Cazares is obviously coming in and he's expected to give you a test, but when are we going to see you back on the world stage in those sort of elite fights?
Hopefully the start of next year. There's already been talk of Jamie McDonnell, there's been talk of Lee Askins as well, but he's boxing in December, so I don't think that'll happen at the start of next year, but hopefully we can get the Jamie McDonnell fight. We know there's already been talks there, so, and there's been offers made, so hopefully we can get on with that.
Ideally, who would you like?
Jamie McDonnell. He's definitely the name what everyone knows at bantamweight, so he's the fight we want. It's a fight that's been talked about for a long time. When I was previously at bantamweight, it got talked about. I went back down to Superfly, now back up at bantam, it's been talked about again, so I'm sure it's a fight everyone wants to see.
Jamie McDonald's obviously just been out in Monte Carlo. He was Libero Solis. What was your opinion of his performance?
Shocking. Honestly, shocking. I didn't give him four rounds. I think he lost the fight by three or four rounds himself. And he thought, after the fight, it was a decent performance. He thought he won it comfortable. I thought Solis won it very comfortable. He was very lucky to get the decision. And to be honest with you, before the decision got made, I had a text wrote out to Frank to say, get me Solis, you're guaranteed a world champion. I waited for the result to get called out. Obviously, the text didn't get sent because he kept his title, but now I thought, I don't think he deserved to keep his title that night.
Did you see plenty to give you optimism in that performance?
Yeah, but I knew that anyway. I knew before the Solis fight, and I knew how to get to Jamie McDonnell. Once you take his jab away from him, there's not really much there. I know he's a tall, long, rangy kid, but once you get past that jab and you're inside, he doesn't really bring much to the table.
Another route could be Lee Haskins. As you say, he's in Japan on New Year's Eve. If he was successful in that defence, is that a fight you'd like to make?
Yeah, most definitely. Obviously, I wish him good luck out in Japan. Hopefully, he comes back with the title, and if the Jamie McDonnell fight can't be made, then I'm here to box for my old title.
First things first, Scotland. What can the Scottish fans expect of Paul Butler at the end of 2016?
You know what, I'm looking forward to boxing in Scotland. Over the years, I've watched the likes of Alex Arthur, Scott Harrison and all that box there. The atmosphere looks unbelievable, so I'm looking forward to putting on a show for the Scottish fans and getting another win and pushing on for 2017.
After the Jamie McDonnell performance, I guess you're sort of in the shop window a bit, aren't you?
Yeah, most definitely. I need to go out there and put a performance on myself. I can't say his performance was bad and then go out there and bore the crowd myself or put in a bad performance and just scrape through. I've got to go out there and win in style.